As humans, truly grasping the vastness of space is almost impossible. We feel at home in our own cosmic neighborhood, the solar system surrounded by familiar faces like Jupiter, Mars, and of course, Earth. But travel 18 billion kilometers beyond the sun, past the heliopause, and you leave that comfort zone behind. Beyond lies the cold, silent emptiness of interstellar space, a realm only two human-made objects have ever entered, Voyager 1 and Voyager 2. Until recently, only two known visitors had ever crossed that boundary in the opposite direction, entering our solar system from the great unknown. In 2017, Oumuamua, and in 2019, Two. I. Borisov. Those encounters were both thrilling and a little eerie, the strange feeling of meeting something that came from a place humanity may never reach. For 6 long years, the sky was quiet, until a new observation turned our attention back toward the stars. A Deep Field Theory production, where science meets the infinite. In this video, we dive into NASA's latest discovery, the third known interstellar object. 3. I. Atlas. This comet will reach its closest point to the Sun by the end of this year. Since its discovery, this cosmic visitor has gone by several names. But as new data emerged about where it came from and where it's going, what first appeared to be an ordinary space rock soon became one of the most intriguing finds of the decade. On the night of July 1st, one of NASA's Asteroid Terrestrial Impact Last Alert System telescopes, known as ATLAS, detected a moving object during its routine sky scan. ATLAS operates 4 telescopes, located across Chile, South Africa, and Hawaii, capturing nearly 800 images every night. So far, it has discovered over 1,200 near-Earth objects approaching within 1.3 astronomical units of our planet. But that night, the telescope in Rio Hurtado, Chile, captured something extraordinary. Unlike most sky surveys, such as Pan-STARRS or the Catalina Sky Survey, which avoid the bright galactic plane, ATLAS was designed specifically to peer into it. Pointed toward the Sagittarius constellation, it took 4 30-second exposures and spotted a faint object moving steadily toward the solar system. Temporarily labeled A11PLE3Z, the find was quickly reported to the Minor Planet Center in Cambridge, Massachusetts. The MPC, responsible for cataloging small bodies across the solar system, released a bulletin containing previous observations and orbital data. When astronomers analyzed the numbers, they realized this object wasn't new after all. It had been captured in earlier images dating back to June 14th, taken by Zwicky Transient Facility and other ATLAS telescopes. When all the data was combined, the MPC confirmed its orbit was hyperbolic, meaning it wasn't bound to the Sun at all. It came from interstellar space. And just like that, it received its official name, 3I ATLAS, the third interstellar object ever discovered. At first, scientists weren't sure whether it was an asteroid or a comet, but further analysis revealed a faint coma, a glowing cloud of gas and dust evaporating in sunlight. That made its identity clear: a comet. It was also given a second designation, C2025N1. The MPC called for more observations to refine its orbit, launching a global campaign involving some of the most powerful instruments on Earth, including Chile's Very Large Telescope and NASA's NEOWISE Infrared Observatory. The goal: learn as much as possible before this icy traveler disappears back into the void. First things first, there's no reason to panic. 3I ATLAS poses no threat to Earth. Its closest approach will be around 1.6 AU, roughly 600 times farther than the Moon. Its orbit is highly eccentric, around 6 on the scale. For comparison, a perfect circle has an eccentricity of 0, while anything above 1 means the object is escaping the Sun's gravity. A value of 6 makes it one of the most extreme hyperbolic orbits ever recorded. And then there's the speed, 58 kilometers per second. That's roughly 580 football fields every second, making it the fastest interstellar comet ever observed. Oumuamua traveled at 26 kilometers per second. Borisov at 32 kilometers per second, meaning 3. iAtlas is nearly twice as fast. At that velocity, it could travel from Earth to Jupiter in under 1 hour, a staggering pace that defies human intuition. By tracing its path, astronomers calculated its direction of origin, the Lyra constellation, the same region from which the fictional alien message arrived in Carl Sagan's contact. Of course, that's just coincidence. But it adds an eerie echo to humanity's ongoing curiosity about what or who might be out there. 3i Atlas will reach its closest approach to the Sun on October 30, about 1.4 AU, just inside Mars's orbit. Then, like Borisov before it, it will sling back into the dark interstellar sea. To better understand its behavior, the Las Cumbres Observatory joined the campaign. Data from their 0.36-meter telescope in Hawaii revealed a rotation period of about 29 hours, with brightness varying only slightly, about 0.2 magnitudes. At Discovery, it shone around 17.8 magnitude, up from 20 just weeks earlier, and its nucleus is estimated to be 10 kilometers wide, far larger than Oumuamua. It shows both a coma and a faint tail, which has grown from just 3 arc seconds to roughly 25,000 kilometers long. Through a telescope, the tail appears as a ghostly streak, a fleeting message written in dust and sunlight. For a few short weeks, humanity will share its sky with a traveler born under another Sunday. 3i Atlas appears noticeably redder than the Sun, a trait it shares with previous interstellar visitors. Borisov, for instance, was shedding around 50 kilograms of dust per second, and similar measurements are expected soon for Atlas. These findings help astronomers estimate the density of interstellar objects in our galaxy, roughly 1 object per 1,000 cubic AU. An astonishingly sparse distribution. And yet, detecting 3 of them in such a short time hints that our technology and our vigilance are improving faster than we imagined. Borisov was intensely active, with a tail stretching 140,000 kilometers. Atlas is less so. Oumuamua had none at all. These contrasts suggest they formed in different environments or were ejected under very different conditions. Oumuamua likely came from the rocky inner regions of its home system. Borisov, from a cold outer belt, much like our Kuiper belt. And 3i Atlas seems to lie somewhere in between, a hybrid world of both rock and ice. Its speed also offers a clue. Astronomers know there's a relationship between an interstellar object's velocity and its age. At 58 kilometers per second, 3i Atlas is estimated to be between 3 and 11 billion years old, older than the Sun itself. It may carry within it frozen dust from the dawn of the cosmos relics, from an era when the first stars were just beginning to shine. Every atom inside it is a whisper from the early universe. Though it shares traits with Oumuamua and Borisov, 3i Atlas stands apart, a cosmic time capsule, offering priceless insight into worlds beyond our own. Such visitors are extraordinarily rare, and no one knows when the next will appear. From September onward, amateur astronomers can already observe it with mid-sized telescopes. It will reach perihelion on October 30 and reappear in early December on its way out. Even without a telescope, you can track its journey through NASA's JPL Horizon system. 3. iAtlas has traveled an almost unimaginable distance and carries secrets still waiting to be unraveled. So next time you look up at the night sky, remember, among the countless stars, a small traveler from another sun may be passing by, a silent messenger, carrying the story of its distant home across light years for just a brief visit to ours.